In the third lecture on biotechnology principles and processes, we will further move ahead to discuss about the steps that are used in the process of biotechnology. Earlier, we have already learned about identification and cutting of the fragments using restriction enzymes. In the previous lecture, I have already discussed about it. So, after cutting of the DNA, that is the desired DNA as well as the plasmid, now we have to find out exactly which one is the DNA, the gene that is required for us. That is, which is the actually desirable gene. We have to take it out, isolate it out, separate it out. So that separation and isolation of fragmented DNA is the topic that we will talk about today. Now, the method that is used in separation of the fragmented, the cutout DNA is gel electrophoresis. Gel electrophoresis is a technique whereby the DNA fragments are separated on the basis of charge that they possess. DNA being negatively charged will be made to move towards a positively charged end over a gel piece. The gel piece is made up of agarose. So now the principle that is applied, which I just now mentioned, is that the negatively charged DNA is negatively charged. We have already learned about it due to the presence of the carboxyl group. It gets attracted towards positive anode under electric field. When an electric, that means there is a cathode and anode at two ends, and you place the DNA towards the cathode and you run, apply current to it, then what will happen? The DNA will automatically move towards the positive end. Attraction will be there. So that very principle is applied in gel electrophoresis, whereby we will get the separated, separated out fragments of DNA. Now, the medium that is used over which the DNA will move, that medium is called as agarose medium. It is a gel piece that is prepared out of the component that is agar. Agar, which is obtained from gelidium, that is an algae. It is used, and from it is prepared a medium, a gel piece, a sheet that is that we will call as agarose. So here you have the device. This is the device which is used. This is the gel electrophoresis. So here, this is the agarose gel piece. So this is the agarose gel piece because for the smooth movement of the DNA. Then this particular device, it has a positive end and it has a negative cathode. Positive anode and negative cathode, which is connected to a power supply, as you can see here. Now, next, what will happen at the negative side, that is the cathode and some wells, we call this as wells, are present, some points are present, where the sample is what? Sample is the cutout DNA, where we have already applied, added restriction enzyme, and is expected that the DNA has been cut out here. Okay, they have got cut out here. So that sample is taken and is placed in these wells. After placing in the wells, there will be supply of current. So current will be supplied over it. So there will be, okay, electric field. It will be made to run. And consequently, what will happen? The fragmented DNA, the cutout DNA, they will separate out in this manner. Okay, so these small lines that you see here, these are nothing but these are the DNA pieces which has got cut here. So they will move towards the positive end. The ones with lower molecular weight or smaller fragments, we can say, smaller fragments will move more towards the positive side, and the larger fragments will be more towards the negative side, that is the cathode. Why? Here, friction plays a role. Now, the steps, once more, separation. That is, separation means we place the sample into the wells and we pass an electric current. Then after they get separated out, okay, after they have got separated out, what is done? It is stained. Okay, it is stained in ethylene bromide and UV radiation exposure. That means to this particular gem piece, where we have already got the separated DNA fragments, what will be done? A stain, that is ethylene bromide, will be added. Added here, and after which this whole thing will be exposed to UV radiations. It will expose. Consequently, what will happen? You will be able to see some orange colored bands. That means these fragments of DNA will take up the stain, ethylene bromide, and will turn orange under exposure to UV radiation. So you will be seeing some orange colored bands. This step is known as visualization. So after separation, we have to carry this out. Next will be elution. Elution is when we will cut out the orange bands. Now, of course, prior to that, this particular nitrocellulose, this particular agarose gel will be transferred to a nitrocellulose gel piece. Okay, it will be placed over it, whereby the DNA will get transferred to the second gel piece. And in second gel piece, what will happen? The these DNA bands will be cut out. Okay, the orange bands will be cut out. That cutting is known as elution. So after elution, what do you get? You get the separated out DNA fragments. All we will separate out, and then we will study them. We will identify them as to which one is the one that we were looking for. Okay, out of that, and following which we will start with the next steps. Now after this, what happens? We have done our experiment with one particular DNA piece. Now we want to carry it. It's not necessarily the first attempt will be successful. After this, the first attempt will be successful, the cloning. So that recombination, formation of the recombinant DNA. So what can be done? We can amplify the separated gene of interest. That means we can create many copies of it. So that in the further experiments, if suppose we fail in the next experiment, if we fail in the next step, then we need not repeat the previous steps. That is isolation, identifying, cutting. We need not carry out all those steps. We can again start, because we will have multiple number of that gene of interest. That means the fragment, this fragment that we got, we can create many copies of it. Many copies of it, keep it with us, millions of copies. And then one by one, we can use those for our experiments. We need not repeat this gel electrophoresis method. We need not repeat restriction cutting. We need not repeat all the previous steps. So for that, what do? We amplify the separated gene of interest. How do we do? Using a method, a technique called as polymerase chain reaction. In this, polymerase chain reaction is quite similar to DNA replication, but here it will be carried out artificially. The steps are denaturation. This is the first step. Denaturation means separating out the DNA fragments. Okay, so this green part, this is the fragmented DNA, the separated isolated gene of our interest. Okay, so this is the original DNA, which we want to make many copies of it. So what will be done here? The first step will be denaturation. High heat is applied to it. High heat is applied to it, and then very high heat is applied, due to which what will happen? The hydrogen bonds will break in between, and you will get the separated two complementary strands. They will be separated out. The hydrogen bonds have broken. So this is denaturation. How is it done? It is done by application of high heat. The next step is annealing. In annealing, what is done? Already some prepared oligonucleotides. Okay, some already prepared oligonucleotides are added to these separated DNA fragments. So oligonucleotides will be short stretches of nucleotides. Almost all the sequences will be there. Almost all the sequences, like say ATG, TAG, CTG. So that way, almost all the possible fragments will be kept, and they will be let to fuse with the separated DNA. So here, suppose here it was ATC. So what will happen here? G, A, and T. So, GAT, whichever nucleotide, oligonucleotide has these sequences, will come and bind with it initially. Just this short stretch should bind it. Okay, these short stretches are also called as DNA primers. Okay, they are also called as primers. This step is known as annealing. Then, what is used here for binding of DNA? Okay, for binding of these complementary bases, we need polymerase, DNA polymerase. I think you remember, maybe you can recall, if you try to recall about DNA replication, which you have already done in the previous chapter. So there, DNA polymerase is used for binding of the complementary strands. So even here, DNA polymerase is required. But all these steps are being done under high heat. Very high heat is applied. So all sorts of DNA polymerase will not be able to survive. A special type of DNA polymerase is taken here, which is named as TAC polymerase. TAC polymerase is extracted from a bacterium, Thermus aquaticus. Now this TAC polymerase, which is actually a DNA polymerase, it is thermostable. Thermostable, why is it thermostable? It will not break down even under high heat, because the bacteria inside which it is found or it exists, that particular bacteria itself is adapted to survive under very hot environment. So consequently, what happens? The polymerase also is capable of tolerating very high temperature. So this particular type of polymerase is extracted from this bacteria and is used in polymerase chain reaction for binding of formation of hydrogen bonds. Next step is extension. So in extension, what will be done? Here, nucleotides. These you can see, these are nucleotides. Such nucleotides will be added. Okay, a lot of nucleotides will be let free in this medium along with TAC polymerase, whereby the nucleotides will go on binding with the complementary strand. Okay, with the two complementary strands, already the nucleotide, the oligonucleotide is there, following which they will start forming the hydrogen bonds in presence of TAC polymerase. So, what do you get now? You get two new strands of DNA from one original strand of DNA. So, after formation of these two new strands, okay, two new strands from one original one, original small DNA part that are gene of interest, we have recreated into two. Next step will be amplification. In amplification, what will be done? This individually, these two daughter strands that we got, they will be again made to pass through this denaturation, annealing, and extension. So what will happen here, you can see, again they will pass through those three steps. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 means denaturation, annealing, and extension. Again they will pass through the three steps. Result, what will happen? They will again form two new strands. Okay, they will form two new strands. So, two new strands. Again they will form two new strands. Each of them will again be made to pass through the first three steps. So this will be repeated. Okay, it will go on repeating. Then after 30 such cycles, 30 times when we repeat, okay, 30 times when we repeat, then we will get 1 billion copies. How? Because this is a geometric progression. Every time you are getting double the number. From 1, you got 2. From 2, you will get 4. From 4, you will get 8. From 8, you will get 16. So every time it will double. So within a very short span of time, billion copies will be formed. And those can be preserved for our future use. So here, the one more figure we have here to show polymerase chain reaction. So this is the region to be amplified. So what is done here? High heat is applied. Due to application of high heat, denaturation step, the DNA fragments will separate out. After separating out, what is done? Some primers, oligonucleotides are added. That is known as annealing. After which extension, that is deoxynucleotides are added, okay, are left here. So according to the complementarity, following the complementarity rule, what will happen? The nucleotides will go on forming hydrogen bonds. Everything in presence of TAC polymerase. So after 30 cycles, as I mentioned, it will be amplified to 1 billion copies approximately. So this is how polymerase chain reaction is done, whereby you get many copies of the a particular fragment of DNA that we want to incorporate, or we want to join, or we want to place inside another organism to get our desired product. Then next, we will go to cloning vectors. That we will be doing in the next lecture. We will be going to cloning vectors.